Well, as the charges have always been sedition, so it is very clear the charges have been on my ideas. One can see that it seems each government considered as dangerous someone who has some influence upon the people, unless, of course, they can use him to gain access to the same people. So since I was not ready to sell my ideas in their market, so they felt that I shouldn't be there at all. And the last regime even went further than that. They felt that I had no right to exist even. After arresting me, they opened fire on those who demonstrated to demand my release, killing a number of people, about 50-something in number in all, and also demolish my house and remove my family, as if, you know, as since I don't subscribe to the ideas of the government, they feel that maybe I don't have the right to even exist. Yes.
So, what are these ideas that people are uncomfortable with?
Because those in not authority. People. Mm. People are very comfortable with my ideas.
Those in authority.
Those in authority are not. Those in authority consider, as I've told you, that someone who has influence on people to be dangerous. And my ideas are nothing short of this yearning and aspiration of the people. I only identify myself with it. It's not that I invented any idea of my own. It is my belief that ever since we were captured or defeated by the British colonialists, it has been the yearning and aspiration of our people to go back to the same system of life which was controlling their lives before they were defeated, and that is Islam.
Okay.
Yeah. 100 years before the coming of the colonialists, the Sheikh Osman Dampodio, after waging a jihad, had established an empire or a nation based on moral teachings of Islam, which the people, at least of our own side of the country, identify with. And after their defeat, you know, the sort of the colonialists used the emirs a sort of way to get to the people. So the people could see the emirs, but the emirs were no longer the leaders. The colonialists were. I will say the same situation up till now. the successive religions have been using the emirs as if they are religious leaders. To get it to the people. So I identify with the idea of the people that we ought to be governed by our own beliefs.
Okay.
Yeah. And since we are Muslims, it is Islam that should absolutely govern our life.
Okay.
Well, that goes well with the people.
Yes, that seems to be...
not with the government. Mm.
Yeah. That seems to be a contradiction in terms of the fact that we now have, you know, even before we come into the democratic arrangement we have in place now, we had a military regime, you know, or whatever governments we had at that time. In other words, you would have preferred that whoever would be head of state or whoever would be the leader of the people, even at the local government level, at the state level and all that, would be Islamic scholars or what?
No, we are speaking about the system, not necessarily the people. Islamic system is basically a moral system, a system based on moral principles designed, which linked mankind with his creator.
Okay.
So he is seen first and foremost as the creation of God and representative of God on us.
Okay.
This us was created by Allah. This is our belief. The we who dwell on the earth are created by the same God. And that God has not created us for nothing. We should consider what he requires from us first.
Okay.
All right. Now, when you give due to that, you know, you at least recognize that you are a nation that did not come out of nothing.
Okay.
we were created by someone, and Satan seems due for him. I agree that there are people in the same nation who may not share the same views.
Yeah.
But that does not mean that those who share the view should put it aside.
No.
Yeah. That's to say, we have to have a certain compromise level where we don't do away with our own beliefs and we don't impinge on the right of others.
Okay. Yes. That was it.
But what they are saying, the authorities are saying, no, it shouldn't be there at all. But, you know, after many years, it seems, after all the confusions, now people, even those in authority, are speaking with religious language, which means I've not been wrong.
You've not been wrong all along.
Yes.